Welcome back. This short video shows us how to do problems using Adam Bashforth predictor corrector formulae, which we already discussed in my previous videos. So I'll be doing one problem here wherein the formulae is only changing when compared to Milne's, whereas the procedure is exactly the same. So let's apply them in the first problem. Let's read the first problem. Using Adam's method, find y of 0.4 correct to 3 decimal places. Given y dash is given, y of 0 is given, y of 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, all the values are given, and note that we have to get the answer correct to 3 decimal places. So please understand that the predictor formula, you fix your calculator to 3 decimal places, whereas corrector formula fix it to 4 decimal places. Let's begin the problem, starting with writing the given IVP. So we have the given equation, y dash is equal to xy by 2. Initial condition is y of 0 equal to 1. And then the tabular column, if we see, this is the given initial condition. All the values are known to us because h value is given and y4 is our unknown, and we have to calculate using Adam's predictor and corrector formulae. So let's start off with the predictor formula. Let's write it down. This is the formula. Kindly have some idea as to how to remember these coefficients along with the signs. Now let us put n, as y4 is required, and let us put n equal to 3 in this, and we get the equation number 4. Let's compute all that is required on the right side as we did for Milne's. Let us rewrite equation number 4 once again here and then calculate each of the required. We know y3, the value of y3 we know, it is given to us in the table. y3 dash is nothing but f of x3 y3. So we are starting with y0 dash as f of x0 y0, and that's given by xy by 2. So it's just the product of the 2 divided by 2. Then y1 dash is f of 0.1 and 1.01, so product divided by 2, remember it like this. Then y2 dash f of x2 y2, similar manner y3 dash f of x3 y3, so substitute all of them and call it 5. Let us put 5 back in 4 and declare the result of the predicted value correct to 3 decimal places that we required as 1.041, and call it equation number 6. Keep this in mind, and let us now substitute this value in the corrected formula of Adams. Let us now write the Adams corrector formula. Put n equal to 3 in 7, get y4c, get all the values that is required starting from y3. y3 is already known to us. Please fix the calculator to 4 decimal places because the required is 3 decimal places. So for getting the predicted value, we fixed it to 3. Here y1 dash is f of x1 y1, which is a simple one, xy divided by 2. I am fixing it to 4 decimal places, so the answer is correctly 4 decimal places. Similarly, y2 dash also, y3 dash, I have got all the values. This is where I am using the predicted value for y. So y4p dash is the value that we have found in the predicted part is substituted here for y, and I get this result. So let us substitute all these together, which I call it as 9, back in 8 to get the corrected value and check whether it coincides with the predicted value. Please remember the predicted value is 1.041. Let's see what we get here. Let's substitute 9 in 8 and get the result, simplify this expression and get the value of y4c. If you see that y4p was also 1.041, exactly correct to 3 decimal places. So both these match correctly, so there is no further correction required. Since this also when rounded off will become 1.041 to 3 decimal places. So there is no further correction, and so time to declare the result that y4 is, that is y of 0.4 is 1.041. correct to 3 decimal places. So if you have seen that there is no change in the procedure of doing the problem, it's only the formula that changes. So there's not much of rework that I have to do here. So some extra problems have been given. So please attempt such problems. Check your answers. These are some extra problems that I have given you. Please cross-check. Almost everywhere we have done, given you the values, except in the place where we have to calculate here using Runge-Kutta method and here using Taylor's. But otherwise, normally in the exam point of view, the values are given. If not, it will be for a higher set of marks, which are not for merely 8 to 10 marks when they are not given. So please understand the procedure of multi-step methods. These last three videos focuses on this. And I hope you all have understood the difference between single step and multi-step methods of solving the IVPs for ODEs. Thank you for watching all the videos. I appreciate your patience. I hope and pray that you all do exceedingly well. All the very best. Take care and God bless you all.